Dear students, let's discuss logarithmic functions and their properties. Till now, you might not have encountered the logarithmic functions. First time we are going to discuss. In detail, you will cover logarithmic function in your mathematics class. Here, I am just giving you the brief idea about logarithmic functions as well as their differentiation also. Say, if you are given with an equality like a is equals to b to power c. When we calculate the numerical value of b to power c, if b and c are two numbers, we get another number a. Now, this form of equality we call exponential form. Because here we are representing a number in terms of another number having some power. Now, the same expression or same equality can be expressed in another form which we call logarithmic form. This logarithmic form, when we talk about logarithmic form, it is written as log of a is equals to c, where the base of this log is b. This is the way to express the same equation a is equals to b to power c. But this way of expressing the same equality is called logarithmic form. Now, in this logarithmic form, this is the log function. Here a is the argument of log, this b we term as base of logarithm, c is termed as value of logarithm, and a here is the argument. It is just the argument of which the logarithmic function value c is being calculated when it is calculated at base b. Like, for an example, all of you know 2 to power 3 can be written as 8. That means it can be written in logarithmic form as log of 8 to base 2 is equals to 3. For another example, we all know that 3 square is equals to 9. Its logarithmic form can be written as log of 9 to base 3 is equals to 2. Anything we can calculate, like for another example, 25 is 5 square. So here we can consider log 25 to base 5 is equals to 2. There are several ways by which we can analyze whenever there is a numerical value having some power. Its result can be expressed in form of logarithmic functions. Logarithmic functions are just another way to express exponential form of functions. There are lot many utilities of logarithmic functions, which are also called logarithms. But the application, mean details and application of logarithmic functions, you are going to study in mathematics. Here, we are just limiting ourselves up to the differentiation of basic logarithmic functions and their properties. Now we'll discuss one more logarithm, which we call natural logarithm. It is just log function with base equal to e. E is a constant which is extensively used in mathematics as well as in physics also. It is just a constant which is 2.71. This is also called exponent value. And this constant value is quite important in lot many cases of physics as well as mathematics. Right now, we are just limiting ourselves to the particular value of this exponent value. We are not getting into depth. Just you should keep in mind, whenever there is a log function with the base e, then this log function we call natural log. Like, for an example, if you are given with y is equals to e to power x. Here you can see the power is containing the variable. So obviously this is an exponential function. Now this can be represented in logarithmic form by writing like log of y to the base e is equals to x. This log of y to the base e, which is having a value x, is called natural log of y. It is written as natural log of y. And just to differentiate it from the common logs, there is another way of writing. It is written as ln y is equals to x. And you can simply keep in mind, whenever you find some term like ln is written, that means it is log with base e. This is also called natural log of y, which is written here as x. There are some standard properties of logarithmic functions that we'll study, and these are also quite useful for analyzing various mathematical logarithmic functions also. We'll discuss some standard properties of logarithmic functions. We are going to discuss four properties, just list up one by one, and try to keep these things in mind by regular revision. If you are given with the log of two quantities having in product form, like log of A into B having a base say x, so this can be written as log A plus log B having same base x. Another property is, say you are given with log having argument a by b in quotient form with the same base x. It can be written as log a to the base x minus log b to the same base x. Say we are given with the log with the base x a to power b. In argument we are having a to power b. Then it can be written as b log a with the same base x. These are the three fundamental properties, and there is a fourth property which is a special property which we also call base change property. This is also quite extensively used in physics as well as in differentiation of logarithmic functions also. This base change property is used to change the base of log. Functions like if you are given with log a to the base x, it can be written as log a upon log x, and now you can put any base, say b here, or it can be written as log a upon log x, I put the base e, which can be written as ln a by ln x. Whenever you are given with log of some argument having a particular base, it can always be written as log of a upon log of x. And now you can put any base whichever you like, or whatever is the base which is involved in calculation of a particular problem. So these are the four properties of logarithmic functions which are quite important for you. The details, derivations of these properties you are going to study in mathematics in future. But right now I have given you the properties because in physics these are also going to be used extensively, which you just need to keep in mind and apply directly.